Hello, Francesca Rigucci here with
Peter Buxbaum.
Hello, and today we are talking about throwing away those print ads and leveraging your valuable money, towards the social media advertising.
That was my print ad.
And this,
my
print this is Peter Buxbaum's print ad. See how small the photo is? So we're going to talk about how you can take the mindset of the print ad that I'm sure many of you are devoted to and bring it towards social media.
For me, I guess the biggest thing that you and I had a conversation about was the print ad. I can't quantify anything. I can't tell what's coming back. I can't tell if it's been read. I can't tell if it's been opened. I mean, I know it's a postcard, so it doesn't get opened, but I can't discern any value to what it is I sent out other than, oh, I got one call from the 17,000 ads that I sent.
Right, because when you are going through the process of creating a print ad, you do it online, you have a service, you mail it out to all of your zip codes, and you cross your fingers for a week, a month, and just hope that something comes back to you. Whereas if you're leveraging an online ad, you're able to quantify the analytics. They're out there, the impressions, the clicks, or the website views. We're not able to quantify how many people looked at your postcard for 5 minutes or how many people actually looked at it without throwing it to the side.
And the other thing that I've noticed, because I do lots of things, I did the postcards up until she threw it out, but I also buy leads, whether it's Zillow or Realtor Leads. I partner with some real estate agents and I buy those leads. And the thing that I have found of most importance to me is I'm spending money on a volume of leads that I don't even know if they're real. I know nothing about them. So I see them come in and I see the person write the email. But if there's no response, I don't even know if that was a real person coming in. So it almost seems like I'm getting excited over the volume of something that didn't give me anything.
Right. I've seen this happen several times when working with realtors. A lot of our plan when I'm coming on is the social media, is leveraging email marketing and other platforms. And I know that there's a real dedication to websites like Realtor.com or Zillow, because there's a lot of money that you're investing into these websites. You're investing all this money because they're appealing websites. Everyone's on them. Within the office and at office meetings, they're spoken about a lot. And oftentimes, brokerages will strike up deals with this company. And you really need to put it into perspective. Sit on your computer and say, okay, I'm spending X money, and how much money am I gaining from leveraging these platforms?
Yeah, and you and I have spoken because I think my son actually came to me and said that, and he's 30, right, so that puts him in that millennial, that I hate that word, but puts him in that millennial world. And he said, hey, you ought to advertise on Facebook because I just bought something and just advertised on Facebook. He goes, it felt kind of creepy at first because I felt like they knew what I was looking at, which they did. I mean, I got it. His browsing habits then got him, an advertisement came to him kind of targeted towards his browsing habits. Is that how that works?
When you're on Facebook, what you're searching for in the Facebook search with the magnifying glass, what you're putting in your bio, where you went to school, where you live, where you work, your age bracket, your income, Facebook is able to sort and source a lot of this information. I mean, it's unreal the amount of information you could look up on someone with their buying habits, where they go out to eat, or their socioeconomic level. You're able to get very specific on Facebook.
So the advertising that you do on Facebook is more targeted, and it's real people. It's not robots that I think hit a lot of these, you know, online things, but it's real life people that it's targeting an advertisement towards their browsing habits. Is that correct?
You have the real estate websites or that are giving you leads. They're making you happy every day as a realtor because you want to buy and sell, buy and sell, buy and sell. And these websites are giving you maybe 10, 30 plus leads a week. And then these leads, oftentimes you see the name of these leads, you see the email of these leads. If you take one of these leads and Google Yellow Pages them or find them on Google, because there's a website that is the Yellow Pages on Google, and see where they are, see if they're even actual people first,
they may not be.
Before you get excited. Because I know when I'm working with clients, oftentimes they're like, every week, you know, where are the leads? Where are the leads? When the leads are coming in, guess what? Maybe they're not coming in right to your email from Realtor.com or Zillow, but they're asking you a question on Instagram, or they're following your Facebook page. That's a lead. It's a lead because they're interested in your content, they're interested in your message, and hearing you over and over again.
So, contrary to that, then Facebook advertising is more targeted, therefore you can quantify what it is. I spent X, these are real people, I can see what came back to me.
Right, you're able to see a full breakdown in analytics, demographics, age, budget, what your ad's doing, where it's going, whether it's on the mobile platform or the desktop platform. And you're able to see the click rates, the impressions, where they went to. So a lot of that information is laid out for you right away, and you get that up to date. Facebook will alert you that your ad is live, and they will alert you every time you spend money with a daily budget.
You had mentioned content before, and because JT is sitting behind the camera, JT knows that content is vitally important. Content is how we met. You made a comment on Instagram about the content, and I went old school and picked up a telephone. So, and that's how we got together.
Right.
So I do believe content is as important as a real lead. Is it real? Can I quantify it? Can I see it? Can I know what it is? And so that I can see that the dollar spent was more than a dollar earned. If I'm spending a dollar, I don't want to earn a dollar, right? I mean, I got to earn something more than what I spend for it to be worthwhile. And so hopefully that targeted advertising does that.
And as a realtor, you have to shift this mindset of, I'm going to send out 10,000 mailers and I'm going to get a lead out of it. Or I've been doing mailers and I'm successful with it. And guess what? If that's the truth, that's great for you. I'm glad. And I want you to think for a minute. You think, okay, what type of realtor are you? What is your advertising? Are you only using print? Are you only using a Realtor.com or a Zillow? Are you on social media? You need to get the mindset from the print or the methods of real estate advertising that a lot of realtors use, because guess what? It's a big market.
Well, you do have to be diversified. So, and JT and I discuss this a lot. So for me, I'm not just print ads. I'm not just Instagram. I'm not just Facebook. I'm LaSalle University.
Right.
I'm Lunch and Learns at small and mid-sized companies. I teach at Schlicker Kratz. So you do have to be all over the place, and then you get to later kind of see what works, what doesn't work. I share in lead buys with Zillow and Realtor.com with select agents that I do business with, and there's no doubt I get some business out of it, but it is definitely harder to track the business that I get doing that than it is anything else.
And I would say, put yourself out in person at as many places as possible. You know, the Schlicker Kratz is great. Doing Lunch and Learns is fabulous. I love to present in front of a group of realtors. It really gets me very excited to be able to talk to people, and that's really the magnetism of what this is about, is connecting with someone in person. And that's the main goal at the end of this advertising on social media, is connect with them in person and strike up a deal.
I think the biggest thing that I've learned in talking with you has translated into other things. So for argument's sake, I know somebody and I were recently talking about videos for listings. And the comment back was, yeah, but my listing is selling very quickly, so I don't really need the video. And I keep laughing. The video was not meant to sell the listing. The video is meant to get you the next listing.
Right?
The videos don't sell houses. houses sell houses.
Right.
So the video is not just a means to stop thinking it in terms, don't go so narrow to think that the video sells a house. The video becomes the next opportunity to get the next listing, because look what I did for my last listing. Kind of broaden your base a little bit.
And what else is exciting with having that video for the next? Because though you're in with one client or a few clients at once, you're always thinking about the next. I am working with some clients who, they really love the social media and what we're doing. They're so excited about it that when they're meeting with a buyer or seller, they want to tell them that they are on social media.
Sure.
And they're using it, and you know, go follow them to really see what they're doing, because they have that history with it, as you were speaking about with the video. They have the proof in the presentation.
Well, I always learn something every time we do this. What I'd like to learn is how we can get a realtor to join us in this conversation. So if any of you are real estate agents that are listening, please join us. It's a lot of fun. I think it's a blast doing, and I do learn something every time I do it, right?
This is a lot of fun, and I want to encourage you. If any realtor out there is using this,
keep showing my
picture. Please, we need you to come out, because this is valuable. Though it has a lot of information in it, we want this mindset to go to other things, because guess what? Like the radio, think back in your years of living, how things have progressed. This will be obsolete one day. It will be, mark my words, and your business will be so dependent on the internet or on social media. If you're not there, another realtor is going to pick up your business.
Well, thank you very much, as always.
Thank you.
This is always fun. So to reach you.
Luck it out, FrancescaRigucci.com.
And 215-740-8999, only because it elicits a very big laugh from Francesca. But feel free to give a call. And again, if you want to be on, we would welcome the opportunity. So thank you and have a great day.
Thank you.